Right, we're going to put you in there. Bonk! Oh, we do need to go back up, though. Hold on. Kiss. Back in black! Don't know why.
Yeah, why the sudden AC/DC?
Yeah.
Well. This might be...
There's another chair here! Like, who keeps leaving chairs here?
Are you sure that's another chair and not the same chair that somehow clipped through the ceiling?
So we need to raise this up somehow.
Raise it up.
Much like the roof.
Hmm.
So I thought putting the sails down would give me something to stand on, but it's...
It does, but not something that'll reach.
Yeah. Well, looks like we're going this way then.
Looks like it.
Or not.
Looks like we're not. Can you go under the truck?
Nope.
Hmm. I don't remember what to do here.
So, this door's probably shut, yeah? Hold on. Just ignore what Kerosene's doing.
Yep. You got some sort of plan. Ah.
No.
Something happened then. Something's going on with that cog up on the left behind the sails. But I don't know that that helped you.
Well, it looks like it's getting some sort of fuel. This isn't going to work, is it? No, it's not going to reach. Do we need to time it? It's when it drops.
No, putting the sails up and down is too imprecise for you to do it on a timer.
Because it's getting fuel from above.
Well, something's dripping onto that wheel and trying to turn it, but failing to.
Because it's not heavy enough.
Yeah, or the wheel is stuck or something.
What have I got? What can I use?
So you've got your repair thing, you've got your water spraying thing, you can turn the engine on. Did that do anything? Did it move at all?
No.
You've got your tow hook on the front and back.
There's nothing on the front though.
No, I mean those attach to very obvious red things.
Yeah. I mean, I was thinking it could be the water thing, but I can't reach it. So if I grab this, go up here, like, there's no way of aiming it high enough.
No.
So I need to raise the truck first, then do that door.
Okay, so what can you do to the truck?
There must be some sort of mechanism below us, or move the truck.
You've got your brake on, does that matter?
I put it on just to stop the engine, but...
Yeah, I honestly don't remember what to do here. Ah! Ah, you're moving the truck.
I imagine when the truck's finished moving, I'm gonna spring up. Oh.
Definitely gonna call something. There you go.
I mean, I was right.
You were.
The sequence of events.
Yep, you were right. You just had to do the one thing before the other thing.
Party over here.
Okay, that opened that door. Gave you access to the fuel.
Yeah, boy.
Steve's going on without you.
Steve wouldn't leave me.
No. Steve's a good...
Steve.
...land boat. Yeah, Steve. He's a Steve.
Well, that obviously ties onto that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the hooks are always super obvious, aren't they? Okay, so you're moving that onto that, and bingo. Lucky it unhooked, really, or that would have torn Steve in half.
Steve's a smart boat.
Preparing the hopper. Nice.
Alright, I'm going to put the sails down, because there's no wind, and they're probably going to get...
Yeah, they'll just bonk onto something anyway, won't they? Cool.
Let us punch the things.
Punch it, Chewie. That was quite a good Chewbacca impression. Have you seen the video of Peter Mayhew, who played Chewbacca? Like, you can hear his voice during the
bloody
scenes.
Hell, yeah, it's hilarious, isn't it?
Yeah.
Han, tell him we're leaving! Where are you going?
I'd love to see that film. Like.
Yes, yeah, I would watch the whole of Star Wars with the original Peter Mayhew lines. Have you heard Dave Prowse? Like Darth Vader?
No.
That is something to behold, because, you know, he's Bristolian.
Yeah.
Here,
Luke, I'm your father.
Commander, tear the ship apart until you find those droids and bring me the passengers. I want them alive.
Why did they replace his... I'm like...
Really, what? Do you need an answer to that question?
But why would they cast him if they knew...
Because he's like 7 feet tall. Or he's like 6'8" or something ridiculous. He's a huge bloke. And he had the right physical presence. I mean, James Earl Jones was quite a big guy. They couldn't have made him look menacing in armour. He'd have just looked like a space Michelin man. he used to be a bouncer in Bristol.
Really?
Yeah, he threw my aunt out of the club at least once.
Nice.
Yeah, that's my claim to fame. Darth Vader threw my aunt out of a club. And he was the Green Cross Code man as well.
He was, yeah. I remember those adverts. Well, I don't remember them, I just remember them existing.
Yeah, me too. I imagine they were like, don't cross the road improperly or I'll beat you up.
You shit. Me babber.
Stop, look, and arc. You seem to be on some train tracks. Steve the Land Train.
You know, if this is like a side game to Snowpiercer.
Don't think it is, but I can't say with absolute certainty that it isn't. I haven't seen Snowpiercer, so...
Decent film.
Yeah, I heard it was alright for a film about a train in the future.
Future trains! Right, we've got to do it. I'm sorry, Steve.
It's alright, just be ready with the repairs. Speed is fueled, but burning.
We've all been there.
Yeah.
It was only the loader that broke, it wasn't the actual engine, it was the fire that caused the engine damage last time.
Okay. Yeah, you put it out quickly enough this time, I guess. I don't know what the different bars mean on the health meters.
I don't know if they actually have a state. I think it's just like 100%, so each one's like 33% damage.
Okay, but getting to 33% doesn't mean
anything. Yeah, I don't think it means anything.
But it does make me wonder why the engine has one at 66 but not at 33. Nope.
Now you've said that, Dave, I can't unsee it.
What? Well, I'm sorry, but what do you want me to do about it? Yep, that's closer. Well done.
Quite you. Hup.
Oh. Ooh. Nearly ran yourself over there.
They're building a settlement.
Yeah. Definitely building something. That's a good tow job you're giving Steve.
Like, to be honest, I think I'd enjoy the game if this was the entire game as well. Like, just...
just jump up and down.
Yeah.
And watch the world go by. While listening to jazz.
Yeah. Jazz.
Nice.
Really great. My mate sent me all of them as WAVs recently.
Excellent.
Fucking brilliant. Just out of context, just like, really great. Cargo line? Tat!
Ooh, oh. Yep, things pick up. Don't miss that. Missed that.
No, that's not a thing.
No, okay.
It's a button.
Ah. So, what are we calling this thing that's towing Steve?
Because it's not a full length Steve, so we're just going to say it's a Steve.
Steve. Okay, I like it. Ah. Goodbye, Steve. I'm leaving.
I have to go now. My planet needs me.
There's Steve parking up.
I'm going to go home to his wife and kids.
Yep, he's finished his shift. I always wonder if you're going to miss them. And you never do. You've got eyes like a badger.
More like a magpie.
I wouldn't go that far.
A red-eyed magpie.
Definitely a keen-eyed badger.
Well, that's that mystery solved.
Yep. Yep, the mystery of Stee.
The mystery. Come on! Come on!
No, I won't. Oh. I won't come on. There is a limit. There is a limit to what I will take.
I think that was pretty good wordplay.
Do you?
Yeah, I do.
Well,
don't at me.
That's why I'm leaving you.
Plus the kids.
No, we're done. We've tried to work this out, and your puns are just too terrible.
Get in there.
Quite a nice snowy day, no?
Was that like a rail station?
I don't know. It's hard to say. Maybe a monorail or something.
Yeah. For all D's nuts.
You've got wind power if you want it.
I do want it.
How badly do you want it?
All of it. I want all of it.
All just... the wind.
Just having a jump.
Yep. Are you on ice?
Yeah.
That's not good, is it? Generally.
Well, it depends. It can be really thick ice.
Mm. So you're like an ice road trucker?
Basically.
In Steve. Nope.
Well, that was bound to happen at some point.
It was, wasn't it? Steve's always banging his sails.
You kind of have to bonk it. Like...
Was that your chair that flew out then?
I think it was. Goodbye, chair. The thing is, it might be over there.
Let's go find out.